Jesse, who was born in New York, U.S., later moved to New Jersey, was a chubby Asian kid with glasses. But because Asians were not common in her neighborhood, she was teased at school for a long time. Jesse had two older brothers, so she could have told them that she was encountering problems, and maybe in this way she would have been able to end this, but she didn't. That's why Jesse, who didn't want to lean on anyone to solve her own problem, was subjected to racism and teasings for years. But one day at school, a boy made a slant-eye gesture to her, and that was the moment she suddenly thought of, "Why should I be treated like this?" And for the first time at this moment, she was unable to hold back her anger, and she immediately threw the table towards the boy. And at this time, the teacher didn't punish the boy but Jesse, who was the victim. However, there was no further harassment against her from that time on, so she learned one thing in that way. Just because I look different, I've always been the weak one. Fighting may not be the answer, but I have to deal with it when I am treated unfairly. So a little girl without a voice learned how to speak for herself against unfair treatment. Jessie, an 11-year-old girl who just regained confidence, first encountered music at the church youth choir. The young Jessie did sing at the church, and her natural voice was so incredible that people around her cheered her up to become a singer. Thanks to the support from her surroundings, Jessie developed a serious interest in music, and her parents wanted to support this. But her parents didn't have the money at that time, so they only could afford 1 week of vocal training. And her black vocal teacher said to Jessie, "Jessica, I can feel the soul of the black people from your voice, you will gonna be a star." And because of this speech of her teacher, she sincerely started to dream of becoming a singer. After this, she practiced singing alone with the microphone her parents bought her. And Jessie, who enjoyed at that time listening to Korean songs, sent her demo tape to a Korean agency. So in that way, she received notification of acceptance from two agencies, SM Entertainment and Doremi Records. However, contrary to everyone's expectations, she made the contract with Doremi Records, not SM. Now, SM Entertainment is a world-famous agency. But in the 90s, there were more famous singers belonging to Doremi Records, and that's why she had chosen Doremi, not SM. Of course her parents, especially her father, strongly opposed that she will go to Korea. But despite her parents' opposition, at the age of 13, she chartered a flight to Korea on her own, even though she could not speak Korean. After 2 years as a trainee in Korea, she made her debut with her real name Jessica Ho. At that time, the agency invested around $800,000, including enormous marketing. So she made her debut with the album Get Up and song 1 to 2 Steps, packed in a cute concept and with great expectations of her. However, unfortunately, her debut didn't gain much attention and it ended in a disappointment. In addition, Jessie had a big problem at this time because she didn't speak Korean well and couldn't adapt to Korean culture. So she wasn't as happy as first thought, despite making her debut as a singer, which she wished so much for. But at that time, Jessie had always to smile. She couldn't tell her parents about her miserable situation, because she knew her parents in the US would start to worry about her. And she was fully aware that a lot of money had been invested in her. That's why no matter what, the only 15 years old Jessie had always to smile, if it was for her parents or for her agency. Since she was stuck in this situation, she lived like a machine as her agency told her to do. And like that, she was soon gradually forgotten by the people and couldn't do any meaningful activities. Then she got a job offer as a temporary rapper for the at this time popular hip-hop group, Uptown. And since then, she began to gain attention by getting recognition for her excellent rap skills while working with Uptown. But shortly after Jessie could start proper activity and was recognized for her musicality, she faced difficulties once again. One of the members from Uptown was caught drunk while driving, and that's why all activities were canceled altogether. After this, Jessie decided to give up on making music for the first time. And a few years later at an interview, she explained how she felt at the time. "I was just having a hard time. I didn't know if this was really the right path for me, and I felt like I was ignored by everyone." At this point in time, she wanted to give up everything and return to the US. But it wasn't possible because of her contract with the agency. Thus, she released a new album, Life is Good, like her agency told her to do. However, Jessie's real life didn't run like her song life as good. In fact, she was very unhappy. Recalling that time, she once said, "On the stage, I had to sing a song saying that life is so beautiful. But every time I had to sing that song, my heart ached, I missed my family and I was so lonely." Above all, Jessie was still a teenager and the absence of her parents bothered her a lot. Still, she had big problems communicating in Korean, as well as the adaptation to the Korean culture, and all of this caused unimaginable stress. And as a result of what happened at that time, Jessie became claustrophobic. At that point, she made a decision and thought, "After this album and its activities, I will go back to the US as soon as possible." And right after the activities from her contract, Jessie gave up her dream of being a singer and returned to the US. But even after returning to the US, Jessie was not really happy. She thought she disappointed her parents after leaving home to live her dream, but eventually returned home without achieving anything. But they were just happy and satisfied that their daughter had finally come home safe and sound. After all that difficulties, she started to study and passed the GED, the high school equivalency diploma in the US, and also began to study fashion, not music. But the music didn't let her go. Because Jessie's talent was so outstanding that the people around her encouraged her to continue her music career. Due to this encouragement, she began to cover songs of other singers and posted the videos on YouTube. And seeing those videos, one day a Korean music agency contacted her and wanted to make a new album with her. Feeling happy while singing, she decided to take the challenge and do music again, and took her second flight to Korea. With this joy in mind, Jessie had the feeling for the first time that the music did choose her, and later wrote these lyrics. "I didn't choose music, music did choose me.
I didn't choose it, music chose me."
Unfortunately, however, her second start in Korea was even more miserable. Shortly after she arrived in Korea, the situation of the new agency suddenly worsened, and her contract was cancelled. Due to this situation, she had no agency, no house, and was alone again. And because she had no place to sleep, she even had to sleep in a public sauna. Going through such a difficult time in her life, she tried to find a new agency on her own in Korea. Fortunately, she signed a contract with the YMC agency. However, despite finding a new agency after such a hard time, she only featured on other singers, but did not achieve much in her solo album activities. In a situation where everything was not going well, the agency recommended plastic surgery for changing her image. So she had to force herself to perform double eyelid surgery and had her nose done. And that led to frustration for a long time because she thought, "My face looks like Pinocchio's," and was completely dissatisfied with her unnatural appearance. But how can a person's life be so miserable? Although she had plastic surgery to change her previous image, she didn't get much attention afterward, and her music activities didn't improve either. Later, she started to work with a group called Lucky J, but also with them, she did not receive much attention. And with getting older, she was already in her late 20s, she wasn't able to continue these challenges over and over again. Although at the age of 13 to 26, literally half of her life she had been doing music for 13 years already, she was still just one of the many musicians. There is a saying, "God won't give you more than you can handle." However, the ordeal she experienced over 10 years of time consent was not at the level she could handle. So Jessie decided to give up on making music for the second time. But even at that time, the music wouldn't let her go. One day a producer from a music show asked her to appear on his program. However, at this point, Jessie had already closed her mind completely to make music, due to the countless failures and the wounds she had already suffered as a result of it. Nevertheless, the PD didn't give up, and through his persistence, Jessie finally joined the program. And this program was Unpretty Rap Star. Jessie, who participated in the survival rap program, shocked Korean society with powerful effects and aggressive expressions, which was uncommon in Korea at that time. Also on this show, she refused to get an evaluation from the other participants, and showed an unplanned improvised diss rap.
"We're not a team, this is a competition. Now in this game, I'm the top dog. 0 to 100 on your head is on my Sin City."
After that, many Koreans thought that in order to get the attention, She purposely swore and only used aggressive expressions. But this was not the case. At that time, there was a reason why she behaved in the program like that. For more than a decade, she had tried to gain recognition and acceptance by others, but the result was miserable. So from then on, she didn't care if she was good enough in the eyes of someone. There was simply no more reason for that, because she had given up music already, and she had decided to finally get the music out of her life after this program. So she did let out all her anger, and she didn't hold back on any of her emotions. After showing all her feelings on stage, she thought everything was over. But in reality, it was the turning point in her life. Korean society was shocked by her intense appearance, which had never been seen in Korea before. And on this point, she received tremendous attention for the first time since her debut. Paradoxically, she was able to work as a singer again because she gave up on making music. Many people thought Jessie, who was making music for more than 10 years, would have been very grateful for this huge interest and the love that she gained through this. But it wasn't like that, and her life became even harder after that. She was fully aware that she was making the headlines only because of her strong performance and personality, and not because of her musicality, which she had worked so hard for. In addition, after Unpretty Rap Star, many began to make malicious comments and the public only misunderstood Jessie even more. No matter how hard she tried to show who she really was, people thought Jessie was only a person with a strong image, and she hated that way of thinking. Moreover, due to some harsh malicious comments, she even thought of an extreme end choice. But after remembering on her parents, she came to her senses and thought, "If I disappear from this world, what will happen to my parents?" While thinking about her parents and enduring this hard time, she released the song, "I Want to Be Me." And this song is still her favorite song, also it's the last song she is singing at every concert. The song "I Want to Be Me" was written out of the pain of worrying about her poor performance as a singer and her career path during a long hiatus. Anyway, even after Unpretty Rap Star, she suffered for a long time. But she was able to make her name known to the public for the first time after 10 years, and with thus the second act of her career began. After various activities, Jessie moved to the Saeyi's agency P Nation and published Who Dat Be, thus expanding her range of activities far beyond Korea to the world. The song Who Dat Be showed that she was no longer minding being criticized, but instead was proud to be herself. This song was ranked 8th in the US Billboard World Digital Song Charts, and showed that she had the potential to be a world-class singer beyond Korea. In 2020, she was invited to the Grammy After Party as the only Asian woman, and received many cooperation offers from other world-class producers. It looked like Jessie had finally entered the US music market, but all of her US debut plans had to be cancelled due to the COVID pandemic. However, even in this unpredictable situation, she succeeded in becoming a world-class singer by surpassing 100 million YouTube views with her new song "New New Nana." She was so happy, and that's why she cried while thinking back on the previous 10 years. Because it has taken too long until she finally achieved her goal and was really successful. It took about 17 years to become a world-class singer in 2020, since Jessie started her trainee career in Korea in 2003. This was the first moment when her hard work as a singer has been recognized, so she cried a lot. Also at that time, she appeared in Running Man and started a relationship with Yoo Jae-suk. With his support, she has shown improved hosting skills and is loved by more and more entertainment shows like Sixth Sense and Jessie's Showterview. Jessie had to face a very long and difficult time over 10 years to get to where she is now. She participated in every lyrics for her albums and always writes similar messages in the lyrics. Messages like this: "Just because you and I are different, doesn't mean I'm living my life wrong. We only have one life, let's live it nicely." She always packs this message in her new songs because she wants to convey this important message to as many people as possible. "I wish this message, which Jessie would like to convey to everyone, will reach more people and give hope to those who are going through a hard time. Just because you and they are different, doesn't mean you are living your life wrong.